Welcome back, everybody. Josh Shernoff here for a very special Fight in Focus. AEW Dynamite premieres on TNT, on Fight TV. And I just want to remind you again, AEW Plus on Fight.tv. If you're all around the world, you can watch AEW live. AEW Dynamite, you can watch it live with absolutely no commercials. You can see what's going on in the arena. Tonight, we are here in the Capital One Arena in the nation's capital. And I am joined by the voice of your childhood and the newest voice of AEW, Mr. Tony Schiavone. Tony, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, Josh. Thank you for making me feel old. No, well, it's because I am old. But I'm not as old as Jim Ross.
That's fair.
So I'm not the oldest member of the broadcasting. But thanks, man. It's great talking to you again. And yeah, it's great being here at the Capital One Arena. This is, I was talking to the big guy with a beard.
Conrad Thompson.
I was talking to him, okay. and I think we both agreed, really, this is one of the biggest nights of my life. It really, really is, and it's not lost on me that how important this is and how, you know, the fans, many of the fans wanted me back. Never thought that would happen 3 years ago, 4 years ago, never thought I'd be doing this again. So I'm very, very honored to be here, I really am.
Back about 3 years, 4 years ago, obviously you've been doing the podcast, What Happened When, with
right.
Conrad. What Happened When with Tony Schiavone, with Conrad Thompson. We
got
to get that right.
Yes,
but being a part of this, back on commentary, back as a member of the broadcast team, of course, last night people watched on TNT, man, I'm getting excited here.
Yeah, we're all
people
excited.
Watched on TNT the right. Countdown to AEW Dynamite, which you hosted.
Right.
Could you ever have imagined that even a year ago that you would be back here, back in this building, which, by the way, the last time we were talking off air, last time you were in this building was Starrcade 97.
Right.
Hulk Hogan versus Sting.
That's right.
That's the last time you were in this building. Could you ever have imagined you'd be back for something like this, and especially back on TNT after almost 20 years?
Yeah, it's really amazing. And here's another thing, Josh, is amazing is getting a chance to work with JR again. I never thought I would have that chance. You know, JR and I worked together through the 80s and the late 80s and early 90s, and I never thought I'd get a chance to work with him again, but it's a lot of fun. He makes me laugh, so I'm sure we're going to have a lot of fun at the broadcast table tonight. Get a chance to work with Excalibur is pretty exciting too, because I think the kid is really, really good at what he does. He knows his stuff. But no, I never imagined this. And you know, in January of 2017, Conrad Thompson said, "Do you want to do a podcast?" And I remember saying, "I really don't. I've tried to recreate myself. I tried to change Tony Schiavone from a wrestling announcer to just something else." But did say yes, and look what's happened since then. And it's just amazing. You just never, I mean, I've heard this from Lord Alfred Hayes, who was a good friend of mine, and God rest his soul. He said, "You just never say never in pro wrestling." That's and he's right. You never do. And who knows exactly what form this show is going to take a year from now. I mean, who will be here, who will be wrestling, who will have. So it's really an exciting day for me. And no, couldn't imagine this back in 2017 at all.
So tell us a little bit about how you ended up here, because it's kind of a fun story.
Right.
You shared it at StarCast on your one of the many panels that you were on stage.
Right.
You shared that story. Can you take us through how you ended up back at the broadcast booth, back in professional wrestling here live on TNT?
Well, I had originally had Bruce Pritchard, who's I consider a very good friend and one of the real, real good guys in wrestling, contacted me, and he told me, he said, when I go back to the WWE, maybe there's a place for you in the network. And I said, cool, you know, let me know. And he did get in touch with me. And he said, do you have a chance to talk? I said, sure. And oddly enough, Cody got in touch with me the same time. He said, will you consider coming to work for us? And I said, well, let me see what the WWE has to offer. So Bruce and I came back and forth. I was told by Bruce I had a job with the WWE. I didn't hear an offer from them. Bruce said, Cody said, Tony Khan's going to call you. And Tony did. And I went down to the Jacksonville Stadium, the TIA Bank Stadium, had a meeting with Tony. It lasted 7 hours with Tony Khan. And it was an all-day meeting. It was great. I walked away from there thinking that, you know, this is probably where I want to be. But I need to hear, you know, what's going to happen with the WWE, and nothing happened with him. Tony is a big-time, old-school wrestling fan. He knows everything. He knows everything. We were in catering just recently, and he was when we were doing Halloween Havoc in 91, JR and I were doing that show in Chattanooga. PN News did a rap. Tony knows all the words to that rap song from 1991. I said, "You're crazy," you know. But he knows all this. He remembers this stuff, and he just—he's a very engaging person, and he's brought wrestling back the right way, I think. So yeah,
he really has. Yeah. It's interesting, him being just a lifelong, just super fan,
right,
of professional wrestling. There's that term in music where they'll say, make the music you want to hear.
Right.
That's what he kind of has the opportunity to do now. And in a way, everyone in this locker room kind of has that opportunity to say, okay, wrestling's been a certain way for a long time now. And you, in the broadcast booth, you have a way to say, like, you know what? We're the guys in the ring and the girls in the ring, we're going to put on a wrestling match that we want to watch.
Right.
You, behind the broadcast booth, it's going to sound the way we want to hear.
Right, right.
And I think that's exciting. What are you most looking forward to about this challenge? Because it's a challenge. No matter, I mean, you've been in the business. I don't want to make you feel old.
Yeah, I understand.
But you've been in the business.
A long
time. You're a veteran in the business.
Sure, I get it.
What about this? What is challenging to you?
Mm-hmm.
And what about that challenge is the most exciting?
Well, the biggest challenge to me is the pace of the matches now, mm-hmm. and the many different... It seems to me that everything's got a name now. Every hold, right. every move, every maneuver, if you will, has got a name now. Of many of those things, I'm still learning. So I'm going to be kind of lost in that, and that's going to be the biggest challenge for me. Good news is we've got Excalibur. We got Alex Marvez, who does a lot of prep work for us and just knows the business. They've helped us out a great deal. So I'm walking into this... I've seen more prep work for this show than any show that I'd ever done for TNT back in the 90s. I'm telling you, there's more prep work done for this show. I've got notes, I've got things, which is great. And that's what I'm excited about, being able to keep up the pace of the match, you know, with like the Young Bucks or whenever we see the Lucha Brothers, being able to keep up with that pace. I think it's going to be the biggest challenge for me to be able to do that. But the good news is, you know, Jim's the lead announcer. Jim's a play-by-play guy. He can call some of the action. I can just add some stuff into it. And being able to work with Jim and Excalibur, I think it's going to end up being pretty good. I'm not so sure how good it's really going to flow the first show.
No, it's
because we haven't worked together at all.
Yeah, there's going to be growing pains.
Right.
But I think you've got a pretty solid three guys behind that booth. I feel like it's going to be pretty good.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it too. I'm excited about that. I'm excited about, you know, we are so popular right now because we sold out this building, we've sold out Boston, we've sold out Philadelphia, and there's such a want for something different. I feel very good about being a part of that, and hopefully that I'm not so rusty. Hopefully that what I say can help, quote unquote, put these guys and these girls over, or these wrestlers and these female wrestlers over. I'm really excited about that. So it's a great moment.
Well, I'm excited for you.
Thanks,
I think,
man.
All everyone watching at home on fight.tv, on our Facebook, on our Twitter, we're all over the place.
All right.
Everybody watching is excited for tonight, AEW Dynamite. Tony Schiavone, thank you so much for
taking the time to talk. Good talking
with me
to you
here,
as always, buddy.
Go right now, AEW Plus on fight.tv. Make sure that you can watch AEW Dynamite live. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Schiavone.
Okay, now you are. Can I say something before we go? Are we out? Okay, I can say something before we go. We're going to be AEW Plus going to be on Fight, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Without the commercials.
No commercials. Commercial free.
So I can't cuss during a commercial, can I?
No, you're going to want to hit that little button and turn that cough button there.
Okay.
You're going to turn that off.
No bad language.
But you don't know. He might forget to press that button. But you'll only know if you go to AEW Plus at Fight.tv.
That's right.
Tony Schiavone, everybody. We'll be
Thanks,
right back.
Ed.